But he's been off this year. Missed the first 20 games due to injury. He's played 16 of the last 19 now for Tampa, right into a heavy workload. 900 save percentage. Quite a ways off the 918 that they're accustomed to getting to. And that's part of the reason why Tampa's on the outside looking in terms of the playoff race.
We are underway here in St. Paul. Minnesota trying to snap a three-game losing streak, trying to extend a winning streak in this building against the visiting Lightning, who haven't won here in their last 10 tries. Freddie Gaudreau in for Minnesota. And the shot right on, held by Vasilevskiy. Our TRIA injury report. Born in Elk River, played his college hockey at St. Cloud State. Ryan Hartman has it for Minnesota, comes to center, across for Patan. He's then wiped out at center ice.
They had to pay for RFA rights, and we don't have to get into all that, but it was a heavy haul. And as you know, living up to expectation.
Coming off a game in which he scored a goal, had one here Tuesday night against Calgary. It was his first goal since a memorable night in Nashville when he called the goal the night before. And then followed through with a goal against the Predators the next night.
Yeah, very similar to calling a shot at the intermission, coming out and scoring the next period. He's maybe going to have to make a habit of doing that.
Puck comes loose at center ice. Kucherov moves into the Minnesota zone. Back to Hagel, who's centered for point. He was tangled up with Duer. And on the rebound, Fleury had to come out and make a save.
Stick of 33. But it's a broken play here. Tampa and the forward go to the corner. He's got, I think defensively for the Wild, they want to try to end plays as quick as possible.
Duhaime fights through a hook, a sharp angle shot from close range.
And the Wild were able to find some room. They're going to have to repeat that process 60 minutes.
Stamkos across to Myers, who fires right on. Fleury makes the save. Johansson scoops up the loose puck for the Wild.
But again, the Wild are going to want to end these plays just like that, as fast as possible, because without guys in your lineup, the hard part.
Middleton shot kicked out by Vasilevskiy. And it sure sounds like he will be. Faber fires. Vasilevskiy hangs on. We showed you the list of injured Wild players earlier in the game. John Hines said that Kaprizov is making progress. He was not yet back on the ice, but said he was making progress toward his return.
Well, that's a positive. They'd love any and all support they can, as Brock Faber. Nice little wrister through some traffic.
Johansson fires. It got through. Eriksson Ek fanned on the rebound.
Well, Vasilevskiy here looking through traffic to the far side. That would just happen to hit Eriksson Ek in the pad. Otherwise, it looks like
Lightning come away with it. Got a chance coming in shorthanded. And Fleury kicks that one aside. Into the corner. Paul back to Kucherov. Paul worked out front. Fleury got a stick on it. Puck is loose in the slot and finally clear to the wall by Duhaime.
Possesses. Goligoski touched on in the pregame. Stay out of the penalty box. You can see why.
Goligoski, Merrill, Sheary comes out front, but his shot was blocked. Faber, one touch ahead to Boldy. Boldy to Middleton, fire, save Vasilevskiy. Rebound loose for a moment, and a quick whistle with the puck never frozen. Minnesota just misses in a 0-0 game. Very defensive-minded, tight-checking first period. Perbix on the loose puck for the Lightning. Goligoski around behind, too far for Bogosian. He absorbs a heavy hit. Another long shot, save, Fleury, rebound, they score! Fleury made the first save, and then Darren Raddysh able to chip it by him on the rebound, and it's 1-0 Lightning.
But the fourth line of Tampa is big and physical, as you know, polishing off Alex Goligoski on the wall. Then that's where the mishaps happen again. Raddysh, the D-man, he's up in the play, being covered on the point. He gets inside of Pat Maroon. And where I just got through complimenting the one.
Sheary. Defended there by Rossi. Raddysh on the wraparound scores his second of the night, and the Lightning lead it 2-0. Didn't have a goal all year coming into tonight, just one in his NHL career, but he has two goals, and the Lightning have a two-goal lead.
It's a pretty finish from Raddysh, who's feeling confident after his first goal, but it's the switch there again, the interchange, miscommunication. Ryan Hartman, there's no way he's catching up with Raddysh, and Mermis on the backside doesn't let go of his assignment. Stick is tied up. That allows Raddysh to just skate uncontested to that far post. Marc-Andre Fleury.
Duhaime centers, and Vasilevskiy may have deflected it in himself. They'll sort it out, and he says no goal.
But clearly that's...
And now we're going to get a fight as Maroon drops the gloves. He and Austin Watson exchanging jabs. Watson a heavyweight.
Yeah, Temple's got a couple. It's a good fight. Jabs from Maroon getting Watson off a little bit. Now Watson in a precarious position with that right underneath Maroon's, and he's got no choice but to just grab on. Blood on the visor. Some visor cuts, but it's better than the head injuries you get when they go down. But right at the faceoff here, Watson tries to jump him, connect to the left. Here's the rabbit punches from Maroon that kind of gets Watson spread out a little bit. And then as they adjust, Watson able to just somehow get something on, extending the zone time, but they just couldn't get it free to get the puck low to high and get their offensive routes run.
Here comes Ryan Hartman in, winds and fires, and a pad save by Vasilevskiy. Yeah.
Wes Walls, Stefan Bayou coaching. Terrific stuff, guys.
Sorelli left alone, moves in on the backhand, and a save by Fleury. That you can't work much harder, and yet you've had nothing to show for your efforts.
Well, it's tough, but I mean, it's the same thing. I think you approach the third the same way you would a road game down.
Back. Takes a look, waits, slides it to the side of the net. Back to Kucherov, into the middle, Hedman. Fire scores! Hedman with a blast from the high slot. He's been on a good run with assists. 11 of them in his last 8 games, but this time he's the goal scorer. And the Lightning have a power play goal and a 3-0 lead.
You've had Kucherov a little bit frustrated at times in this game, but now with the power play, some time, space, he gets to get his feel in, make a couple of plays. And then maybe the easiest pass he's made tonight is just the simple one up to Hedman, and a perfectly placed shot outside of Duhr, but inside that far post. Mark. Well, Kucherov got what he wanted there. He's setting that play up. Just Merrill was strong, finished it.
Hagel drives in, centers, and a sliding save by Fleury. To keep the Wild in it, he stops Nikita Kucherov, and it's still 3-0. Rossi after to get in the corner. Hartman joins the fight for Minnesota. Soligoski to Bogosian. Fire scores!
Well, it's been this line that's been the best for the Wild in the third period, and they just win this battle. Ryan Hartman, 2-on-3, gets up to Goligoski, and he's looking shoot, but corner of his eye sees Bogosian, and in an aggressive spot for the weak side D, he collects this puck, finds the lane through a couple Tampa defenders.
At least put themselves in a spot where you make pull Marc-Andre Fleury and try and take a chance here in the final 3 minutes. This one goes off the post. Draw controlled briefly by Tampa. Now Hedman with it. Hedman waits, fires, intercepted at center ice by Hartman. Played it back into his own zone. Hagel pounces on it and scores into the empty net. And that will seal it for the Lightning.
He's going to put this game away, but Kucherov flying up the ice. That's what pulled Ryan Hartman, put him into a bad spot there trying to cover it. The puck ended up coming to him.
On Saturday night against the Blue Jackets. But a depleted Wild club didn't have enough punch here tonight. They scored just one and fall to the Lightning 4-1.